If you use lighting in dramatic and creative ways, your photos will pop out above the rest. And that's what I'm going to teach you in this video. Hi there, it's Marlene Hielema from imagemaven.com. Welcome back, subscribers. And if you're new here, thanks for checking me out. If you're a beginner or intermediate photographer interested in taking even better photos, take a chance on me and subscribe. Okay, let's dive into lighting tips for skateboard photography. Now, the lighting I'm talking about is 100% natural, also known as available light. I use natural light 100% of the time for my skate photos, so I won't be talking about using flash, LED, or other artificial light sources in this video. Let's do a quick light lesson first, so that you understand the basics. Light has four properties: quantity, quality, direction, and color. Quantity refers to the amount of light. Low light is sunrise or sunset, nighttime, and indoors. Bright light is midday sunshine, using your flash or other lighting. Quality. Now, light can be hard or soft. Sometimes that's known as high contrast and low contrast. Bright sun produces hard, contrasty light. Shadows are deep and dark. On an overcast day, you'll get soft light. Detail in the shadows will be visible. Now, if the air is polluted or smoky, you'll also get soft, low contrast light. Direction. Natural light comes from the sun. If it's sunny, it's really easy to see where the light is coming from. You just have to look at the shadows for clues. Now, if it's cloudy, it seems like the light comes from everywhere and nowhere. Now, skate parks have concrete, so the light can also reflect and bounce onto your skater. Light has color, and that creates mood in your photos. On a sunny summer day, the color of light is neutral. Sunrise and sunset will give your photos a warm look. This is called the golden hour. Skin tone will be orange or red. Air pollution and smoke can also warm up natural light. Now, cool light happens when you're in the shade or it's really cloudy or overcast. Shadows and skin tone turn bluish. It definitely changes the mood. You can control the color of light in your photos by adjusting the white balance in your camera, but I'll cover that in a future video. This is how I use 100% natural light creatively. I prefer shooting skate photos on bright, sunny days with a large amount of light. I can get a fast shutter speed and freeze the action. I shoot in shutter priority mode with a shutter speed of 1/1000th of a second or faster, and I keep my ISO at 800 or less. I love working with shadows in my skate photos. They add visual interest, plus they can fill in missing information when shooting a trick. Here are the steps for shooting on a bright, sunny day. First, look where the sun is coming from. Shoot with the light falling on the front of your skater. Now, if you want side shadows, shoot with the light coming from the side of the skater. Heck, why don't you try pointing your camera into the sun so the light is behind your skater and you'll get super dramatic results. Now, when the sun is a bit lower in the sky, you get really long shadows, and that's a recipe for great compositions. It's really fun to just play with natural light. Don't be afraid to point your camera anywhere. Learning to see light does take some practice. Take lots of pictures. Grab some skater friends and practice working with light and shadow. Review your photos. What properties of light make certain photos stand out over others? You will eventually learn to see light even before you take any photos. This is part of becoming a better photographer. Okay, so now we're going to go through some photos and you're going to describe the light using the properties I just went through. What makes these photos stand out? Your own skate photos. If you have any natural light questions, put them in the comments below this video. I'll be happy to answer them for you. Thanks for watching. It's Marlene Hielema from imagemaven.com. Now, if you missed part one or any other parts of this series, you can check them out too.